Hello students, in previous class I was discussed about KCL and KVL. In this class we will discuss what is mean by nodal analysis. And here the nodal analysis is the combination of Ohm's law and KCL. So here in nodal analysis we have three or four methods. First we will consider simple method, that is the circuit consisting of V1 and V2, only voltage sources and only two sources. So here first step is, here we have to note down how many nodes in the circuit. So in this one, A node is there, B node is there, and third one we are assumed as a ground, and we are connected to ground which is having zero voltage. So by using nodal analysis we will calculate node voltages at A node and B node. So first step is applying the nodal analysis for node A. This is the first step. Again you have to redraw the circuit for only circuit with reference to node A. How many elements are connected to A node? Then only you can solve very simply. Applying the nodal analysis for node A. So here I am assuming that all the currents are leaving from the node. Just I am assuming as all the currents are leaving from the node. So once it is leaving, the current direction is positive. In some textbooks it may be different, but in this lecture I am assuming that all the currents are leaving and I am taking as a positive. So here I1, I2, I3 is equal to 0 according to the KCL. Sum of currents at particular junction or node is equal to 0. So what is I1 here? What is I1? I1 is the potential difference between the VA and V1 by R1. So what is current? Voltage by R. But here we have two different voltages, that's why potential difference between the two points by R1. Similarly, what is I2? Potential difference between the node A and 0 by R2. That is VA minus 0 by R2. So what is I3? Remaining is this one. The potential difference between the VA, VB by R3. So here VA minus VB by R3 is equal to 0. So this is the nodal equation for node A. Similarly, applying the nodal analysis at node B. See here, again you have to redraw the circuit consisting of only elements connected to node B. So here also very simple. I'm considering all the currents are leaving from node. So that is I3, I4, I5 is equal to 0. So what is I3? It is not I3, just as I3. Okay, I3. So what is I3? It is VB, the potential difference between the VB, VA by R3. See here, VB, VB minus VA by R3. What is I4? This one, VB minus 0 by R4. That's a C. VB minus 0 by R4. And here I5 is equal to potential difference between the VB, V2 by R5. So here, so VB minus V2, again here we have minus potential, minus is there, so that's why minus of minus is becoming plus, VB plus V2 by R5. So this is the nodal equation for node B. Very simple method. consisting of only voltage sources. In second method, the circuit is consisting of one voltage source and one current source. So when it is consisting of current source, then problem becomes very simple compared to two voltage sources. So same method here also. I am assuming node. I am applying the nodal analysis for node A. Again, I am drawing the circuits here. So consisting of elements which is connected to node A. So here all the currents are leaving from the node. Assuming all are positive. So first one VA minus of minus plus V1 by R1. Next VA minus zero potential by R2. VA minus VB by R3. So when we are applying the nodal analysis particular node, assuming that node is the superior, that node is the boss, you have to subtract other voltages from the reference node. So here reference node is the VA. So next, redraw the second node circuit. So here it is consisting of current source. Very simple. If it is consisting of current source, then the value is directly given. So just you note down the equation VB. Here we are applying the nodal analysis for BB, means B is the reference, B is the boss, B is the superior than VA or whatever sources. So VB minus VA by R3, VB minus 0 by R4. So here a little bit change is there. It is not consisting of voltage source, it is directly given the current source. Means the potential difference between the two points and by R5, the value is directly given as the 5 amps. The current source is given, means it is directly given that 5 amps is flowing in that circuit. So directly we can take, see here, this is towards node, that's why it is minus 5. So here VB minus VA by R3, VB minus 0 by R4 minus 5 amps equal to 0. So this is the second method. So circuit consisting of voltage sources and current source. In third method, so this is called super node analysis. What is meant by super node? Super means it is something different. So here super node analysis is the voltage in between two nodes without resistor. So this is the third case. See here, in between VA and VB, between the VA and VB there is no voltage, there is no resistor, only voltage source is present. So if the voltage source in between the two nodes, then it is called super node. Example, we will consider a small problem. With this one we will explain what is meant by super node. So same procedure, applying the nodal analysis for first node. So here we have four nodes. So fourth node is the grounded V1. Applying the nodal analysis for node 1. So all the currents are leaving from the node. So here the current source is directly given and it is towards the node V1. That's why it is minus 10 amps and V1. V1, see, assume V1 minus V2 by 2, V1 minus 0 by 3. So this is the normal nodal method. Why? Because there is no voltage source in between the two nodes. But so this is the first equation, minus 10 V1 minus V2 by 2 V1 minus 0 by 3, first nodal equation. Second nodal equation, if you observe, the voltage source is in between the V2 and V3. So here the difference, the potential difference between the two points is equal to voltage source. That is, first we have to consider which potential is greater than positive. So here V2 potential is having the positive, V3 potential is having the negative. So that's why V2 minus V3 is equal to how much? It is So it is 5 volts. The voltage source value is 5 volts. So here V2 minus V3 is equal to 5 volts. Somewhat here it is became wrong. It is in this 20 is wrong. It is 5 volts. So this is the second nodal equation. For third nodal equation, we have to consider all the nodes except supernode or that source value. So here I am considering all the nodes. See, just observe here. V2 minus V1. See here, V2 minus V1 by 2, V2 by 3, V3 by 1, V3 by 5, V3 by 1. So here I think this is became wrong. V3 by 1, V3 by 5, V2 by 3, V2 minus V1 by 2. So just leave that voltage source value and considering V2 and V3 at a time. This is called supernode. So V1 just normal method, but V2, V3, in between V2, V3, one voltage source is there. Just leave that voltage source. You write nodal equation for V2 as well as V3. So this is called supernode method. And third one, inspection method. So this type of problems we can use in the competitive examination or in terms of gate we will use. So here inspection method is very simple. VA, assuming VA and VB. So you write nodal equation, very simple. VA minus V1 by R1, VA minus 0 by R2, VA minus VB by R3, first nodal equation. For node B, it is simple. VB is the boss. VB minus VA by R3, VB minus 0 by R4, VB minus V2 by R5. So in this, rearranging the equations in terms of voltage drops. Current is equal to voltage drops. So what is VA is common? You will get 1 by R1 plus 1 by R2 plus 1 by R3. And common mutual is 1 by R3. Similarly, second equation. So here finally, we got in terms of conductance into voltage, VA is equal to current. That is, current is equal to conductance into voltage drops. So this is the nodal analysis. 4 methods.